Hello, thank you for joining us on another edition of Expert Talks. My name is Sage for Kalkine Media, and today's guest is Axel Schumacher. He is the CEO at HLTH.network, and he'll be sharing with us some insights about running his company, especially in the age where health has become of utmost importance to us here. And he's going to share how technology can help us to achieve our health goals. Bringing on the show today, Axel Schumacher, CEO at HLTH.network. Welcome to the show, Axel.
Yeah, thank you for having me on the show.
It's an absolute pleasure. And we're so glad that you could join us today from the other side of the world. It's always so much fun to speak to people in different geographies.
Yes, it is. No, I'm coming from good old Munich in Germany.
Wow, amazing what technology can do for us. So the HLTH network also consists of the first run-to-earn crypto mobile app. That sounds very exciting. HLTH Run, a genomics non-fungible token or NFT marketplace for genetic and healthcare data. Could you please talk us through this fantastic innovation and the functioning of HLTH Run?
Absolutely. So let's just call it Health Run, so it's a little bit easier. And it's obviously it's a mobile app embedded in a larger healthcare ecosystem. But let me focus first on the app itself. It's what is what we call a move to earn app. So the idea behind is that you are getting incentivized to move, to go run, to just do whatever you want to do more of it. And in turn for your efforts, you are getting cryptocurrency, and that's the health token, which is the major part of our health ecosystem of the whole network. So first of all, of course, the app is designed to incentivize people to move. And especially in areas of the world where people do not have access to modern technology to help them stay healthy, it is of utmost importance to have any help you can get to stay healthy. Like, we have this massive problems with diabetes and other usually Western style diseases that just are simply caused because people sit all day on our sitting on our chairs and not doing anything. And it's a massive problem. And we know from psychology, like, people need incentives to do this. So one incentive, of course, is the providing some rewards, some benefits, like a cryptocurrency. But it's also, it needs to be fun. Like, if it's not fun, would you really do it? Usually not. Yeah, it's just say, come, let's go. So we added some gamification elements to the app, and we are just, of course, at the very beginning of it. But the whole idea is that not only you can earn cryptocurrency, but you can also have and work and build out so-called non-fungible tokens, or like NFTs, on our app. This could be avatars, this could be like athlete kind of avatars that develop and evolve over time. And again, incentivize people to do something for themselves. At the same time, we can work with charities. Let's say you could then choose, say, okay, I don't care really so much about earning crypto with using this app, but I want to do something good, and I give all the crypto I earn via this app to a charity. And since we are the health network, of course, we're aiming at working with a lot of charities that are in the vertical of healthcare. This can be anything from child cancer treatments to diabetes treatment, research, or charities that support, of course, the patients.
That's fantastic. Yes, you're so right. The impact projects are really making waves, with a lot of people jumping on the charity NFTs. But it's so true. Everyone is looking for a way to keep their focus on their health, and wearables and things like that are becoming much more popular with medtech's advancement. It's great to hear that you are trying to get people more aware of their fitness. Axel, in your opinion, what's the significance of apps like H HLTH or Health Run in the present day?
Well, it's really the start of a massive transformation in the global healthcare ecosystem. Everything will be digital in the coming years, and everything will be tokenized, meaning that whenever there is healthcare data, this could be anything from your own genetic data, it could be your medical records, or the data that you save from your wearables, your watch or on your phone, all of this data will be tokenized, which means it can be attached to smart contracts on a blockchain ecosystem. And this is what we are building. And HealthRun is just one part of this massive global tokenized ecosystem. So it gives an entry point for just normal people to be part of this new metaverse digital health ecosystem. And we are really at the very early beginnings of this massive movement and revolutionizing era in healthcare. So what we will see is that people get empowered, so they have more incentives to do something for their own health, and they get suddenly access to a completely new world of products and services that were previously not accessible to them, especially in areas of the world where precision medicine or modern medicine is not really widespread. That's why we are also aiming at covering, for example, the Indian subcontinent. We want to be very strong in Africa. So not only in the classical areas where good healthcare is already available, like in Australia or in Europe or the US. So it's really important to provide modern precision medicine to everyone on the planet, to be really inclusive. And I think with HealthRun, we're doing the very first step into this area, because everyone has a mobile phone. And it gives suddenly people really access to all kinds of digital content. Like we have also a digital, we have a media site. We will provide a healthcare shop that contains products that people can obtain by exchanging it for the tokens they earned in the app. Mm-hmm. But the shop and our ecosystem will provide also services. This could be anything from a test of your microbiome or your genetic test to see if you have any predispositions. And that in turn, you can then use this data obtained to live a healthier, longer life. So we will also enter a completely new world of research and longevity. I'm sure that all the people that go together with us, that they can live longer and healthier.
That is a brilliant mission that you're on. And yes, data definitely has taken turned over a new leaf. It's become so much more valuable in the last 10 or so years. And I think with this emergence of Web3, users and content creators and people in general are becoming more in control of their own data instead of the big techs having control of it. So your app, your crypto protocol sounds very interesting. Do you think it'll ever emerge into the space of you selling on the data to medical businesses who are looking for people for medical research and things like that?
Well, we are not directly selling data ourselves, but we are giving users the opportunity to do exactly that. That means we empower people to really own their own data and be the master of their own data. And this is so important in the digital world, because usually people have no idea where their data sits or who has the power over their data. It usually resides with large companies like Facebook, Google, or whatever you can, Amazon. And they pretty much do whatever they want with this data. But we are now providing the first opportunity for people to really have a say in this. So they know exactly where data sits and what can be done. So what we did in the beginning when we started the health network, we built what we call a genetic data marketplace where we give the opportunity for people to share their data, for example, with researchers or with the pharma industry or with their doctors or family members. And at the same time, give them the option, if they want to monetize this process. I give you an example. Let's say you are a patient, you have, for example, you suffer from diabetes and you want to participate in a diabetes research project. Then you have the option to share your data in a secure way, in an anonymized way, without exposing your identity to the researcher. And you can get paid by it. So this is also where we have an entry point in our mobile apps, because it taps into a larger healthcare ecosystem of research, of data analytics, and really of a global empowerment of people, a new precision medicine era. And what we do at the same time, and this is we are really excited about this, is we can break down data silos all across the world. Research data, healthcare data is spread all across the planet. It sits on thousands and literally almost millions of databases, or on your mobile phone, on your laptop, at your doctor's laptop. And we can bring all of this data together. And the HLTH.Run app is only one way to go into this direction.
So according to you, Axel, how will technology help the healthcare vertical in the coming months?
Well, we are just at a very crucial point in time, because everything in the digital health vertical will explode in the coming months and years. We are really at the very early beginnings, and companies, organizations need to come together to really build a new infrastructure for healthcare in the digital space. Most countries are not yet up to it. So it's up to usually like always to private organizations like ours, like the Health Network, to move the whole field forward. But again, like we are very inclusive, like that's why we called it the Health Network. It's not just something that a bunch of crazy scientists put together. We are aiming at really building a network of organizations, of companies, of startups that are very innovative, of established pharma companies, government insurances, and of course of 7.6 billion people on the planet that can really participate, work together in one digital space, in one metaverse, and moving healthcare and drug development and precision medicine forward. And in the end, we all will benefit from it. We will live longer, we will live healthier, we can really prevent disease. This is a major impact that we will see. We use data, we need to understand ourselves better. And we are all different. You are different than me. Like, we have different genetics, we have different epigenetics, how our genes are regulated. And we can use all of this information to really have a healthier future for all of us.
It's so great that building a community around healthcare can really help to fight diseases. And just like cybercrime, a global network needs to come together and collaborate to work out the solution. So this sounds like a really fascinating project. And I think before computer code, there's actually DNA code. We have so much code in our own systems. So it's lovely seeing the space intersect, and really keen to hear more about what you have to say. Now, you mentioned you might be starting shops. I've heard of some mobile pharmacies doing really well in America. Could you please tell us a little bit more about what makes the healthcare systems cheaper, faster, fairer, more efficient? Do you see this venture sort of evolving into a pharmacy as well?
Not necessarily into a pharmacy. Like, we can only do so much. But as mentioned, like, we are providing a space where service providers or product providers can come together and exchange businesses. Meaning, if a pharmacy wants to come and join our ecosystem, our network, they can do so and offer their services to our users of our mobile app and of our wider health network. And this can be anything. This can be, of course, not only the pharmaceuticals, this can be genetic counseling, this can be telehealth, speaking with doctors around the planet, diving really into a new metaverse, in a digital metaverse where people can get medical advice without the need to leave their home. And for a lot of people, this is extremely important, and the medical field really recognizes this now. But again, like, we are at very early stages, and we are providing really only the backbone, so we call it the base layer of a new tokenized and digital healthcare ecosystem, like by providing a data marketplace for people to share their data, by a data analytics marketplace to provide the algorithms that help us to understand how we can age healthier. And then we can bring everything together, like this, all the healthcare services, the products, if it's nutraceuticals that are tailored to your specific needs, everything can be incorporated in this massive global healthcare ecosystem. So we really have to work on breaking down not only the data silos, but also breaking down the healthcare ecosystems and exchange data and services. And this can go between countries, and between individuals that previously had no access to each other.
Well, it sounds great that you're giving people an incentive to get up, move their bodies, because a lot of us, like you said at the beginning, are just becoming more lethargic, more sedentary, and not getting into life as much as we should. So we're reaching the end of the discussion. Your insights have been fabulous. Lastly, what are your objectives for Health Run for the rest of 2022, please?
We want to bring it, of course, to the world. We are first targeting the Indian subcontinent. We want to really have many millions of users on our app and help really, in the end, hundreds of millions of people to live healthier and enjoy more of their life, because being fit, it just changes your life. And this is, of course, our main goal, like bring enjoyment to the people. Fitness, health, and if you can achieve that, we are happy.
Exactly. And the best thing about crypto is you don't really need to know how to build it to use it, and hopefully earn some liquidity along the way as well.
Exactly, yeah.
Thank you so much for your time today, Axel. We really appreciate your insights. Did you have any closing comments before we finish the discussion?
Yeah, absolutely. So I can only recommend everyone to check out our HealthRun app, like find it in the Google or in the Apple Store. And again, like, we are at the very early beginnings, and the mobile app will evolve to something really great over time. And it's a very exciting time, and I can only recommend everyone to be part of it and accompany us on our journey.
Yes, it sounds wonderful. Thank you so much again for joining us on Expert Talks.
Thank you.
And if you just joined us, we had a very interesting discussion with Axel Schumacher, CEO of Health.network. And if you missed any part of the chat, you can catch the full interview at Kalkine Media's YouTube channel. So please do subscribe for more of these live expert talks, and reminding you to stay apprised and invest wise with Kalkine Media.